The first European to see Pikes Peak was likely Francisco Vasquez de Coronado, a Spaniard who had explored the area in 1540. In fact, many a Spaniard had likely seen the mountain during their trips through what they called New Spain. After hundreds of years of Spanish exploration, a secret treaty between Spain and France transferred title of an area called Louisiana to France in 1800. Then France's hopes to expand their dynasty were dashed by an uprising in the Caribbean, and the French decided to sell the area. As a result, this vast land expanse was added to the United States in 1803 as part of Thomas Jefferson's Louisiana Purchase. At a price tag of $15 million, the 800,000 square miles reached from the Mississippi River to the Rocky Mountains. Anxious to comprehend the scope of what they had just purchased, the country sent exploration parties west to gather more information and to map out this newest addition to the United States. The well-known Lewis and Clark expedition had explored the northwestern part of this claim. However, another party, led by Lieutenant Zebulon Pike, was one of the first to explore the southern region. Pike and his men left Missouri in the summer of 1806, though today's interstate highway system would allow a modern traveler to make the trip in less than a day. Pike's expedition took 4 months to reach the area. As they neared the front range of the Rockies, Pike spotted what he called a small blue cloud, which later revealed itself to be a towering mountain. When they reached the area that is now the city of Pueblo, about 35 miles to the south, Pike ordered most of his expedition to build a small stockade, while he and three of his men struck out to further explore what he now called Grand Peak. When Pike and his men left St. Louis the previous summer, they had thought their exploration would last less than 6 months. As such, they had not prepared for the cold weather that was now upon them. And when Pike reached the base of the mountain, he certainly felt the effects of this poor planning. Clad only in summer clothes, they would spend only one very cold November day reaching one of the lesser peaks before being forced by the elements to turn back. Many historians and geographers still debate which mountain he did scale, but Pike left the area without reaching the summit of his newly discovered Great Mountain. While many claim that Pike stated no man would ever reach the summit, a closer review of his journal shows that Pike thought the top was indeed obtainable, just not by him at that time, given his summer clothes, lack of food, and waist-deep snow. In June of 1820, Major Stephen Long and 22 men left what is now Nebraska to explore the source of the Platte River. After 3 weeks of crossing the tall grass prairies of eastern Colorado, the expedition caught their first glimpse of the snow-capped Rocky Mountains. Following several more days of marching, the Long expedition finally reached the base of Pike's Peak. Being rather impatient with the progress they had made, Major Long was anxious to continue on the expedition and return home. But Dr. Edwin James, a naturalist with the expedition, whom had been personally selected by Major Long, convinced him to wait a couple of days at this location so James could climb Pike's Grand Peak. Long reluctantly agreed and granted Dr. James a mere 3 days to climb the peak, make his observations, and return to camp. Unlike Pike's winter attempt, James's climb was unencumbered by the weather, and even though the terrain was steep and difficult to climb, James and two men reached the summit on the afternoon of the second day. After completing the long and demanding climb, they only managed to spend an hour on the summit before it was time to start the trip back down. They spent the second night just below the summit, but without blankets or provisions, as they had lightened their load the day before to speed their ascent. On the morning of the third day, they woke to the smell of smoke coming from the ravine to the north. As it turns out, the campfire they had left the previous morning had turned into a full-blown forest fire and now ravaged acres of the mountainside they had climbed on the way up. As a naturalist, this had to be quite embarrassing for Dr. James. James returned to Long's encampment that next night completely exhausted. However, not only had he managed to scale the mountain, he also had made many notes in his journal and returned with many examples of previously unknown plants and flowers, including Colorado's state flower, the blue columbine. Impressed with his efforts, Major Long named the mountain for him, declaring it to be James Peak. However, a later explorer by the name of Lieutenant John Charles Fremont is most responsible for giving the mountain its current moniker of Pike's Peak. Fremont believed Pike had earned the naming rights as the first American to document the existence of the mountain, and he imposed his view by referring to the mountain as Pikes Peak in his journals and maps. Because these maps were used during the Gold Rush days, his influence in naming the mountain was indeed quite overwhelming.